Steve Nestle is bow hunting on the Wendlet Ranch on opening day and has set his mind on a particular deer that's been on the scouting cameras.
It's opening day in Texas. I am hunting a big deer this morning and only hunting him opening day. We're in a really nice tree. We're back up in some good cover in a tree stand right above a river. And we've got a ridge above us where we think they're gonna be feeding as it gets light, and hoping they come down in front. As long as I do my job, we should be good.
I guess this is the end of our first morning in the Texas season opener, and I know that's all I could ask for, except for maybe throwing an arrow at the buck we were hunting. But we saw him, he was about 3-4 steps away from being perfect when he got pushed off, and it all happened really quick. There were a ton of deer in front of us, a lot of nice bucks, just a ton of action from the word go. So again, couldn't have asked for anything more in the first morning. Season opener. I think I got the jitters out of the way. I was anxious coming into the stand this morning, but now I'm just ready to go out and hopefully put the smack down on something. But great start. We're gonna head back to the Wolverine, go back to camp, and see if anybody else was successful this morning.
So the name of the stand is a Cree stand, and it backs up, right? The creek goes right behind the stand. So we're in a tree, actually. It's a ladder stand, again, tucked into the tree. So it overlooked an area that had been trampled down quite a bit. You could tell that the deer were coming through there. And it's just a sweet spot. I mean, a little bit of breeze is always nice in a situation like that. And it was going to be pretty calm. But overall, you know, checking boxes as far as what you'd ask for from a setup, it was checking most of them. Off to my right, I see this big mass of horn and animal coming through, and it's him. He's the first shooter buck in. And there's other deer coming from the left, but here he comes. The three little dinks that were in front of us are gone, because you know he's made quick work of them. He's pushed them out, and he's just coming in front. He goes through to the left. I don't even have my bow off the hanger yet. I got to grab it. So I get the bow. I'm getting ready, getting set, and he's still off to the left. I keep waiting for him to come through, and it's going down quick.
Ready? You got it.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh, no. Oh, yeah. This way. Come on. Oh.
Slow down, big guy. Slow down.
Do you see him still?
I do still. I just lost him on the ridge. I'm trying to mark him because I think it was a good shot. I think. I think that was a good shot. Felt good. He didn't flinch too much. Now I have to wait. That was a big boy. That's the guy we're hunting. He's a monster. I hope the goodness that I made a good shot on him. He is a stud. He is a stud.
Super excited right after this shot. Probably more excited than I've been after any bow shot I've made that I can remember. And I'm thinking, you know, hopefully he just fell over right after getting out of my view, and we're gonna see some sign, we're gonna have a good trail, and we're gonna go up to him after we give it a few minutes. And that kind of unraveled once we took a look at the shot and we looked it back and saw that it was a little back, got down, looked at the impact spot. Clark came in and joined us for some reinforcements. And we found some sign eventually, not a lot. And we went up a couple 10, 20 yards and decided we needed to come back to camp, because not only did we see the shot was back a little bit, we're not getting a lot of sign. And if he's bedded down and he's not dead and we jump him, it becomes a really bad scenario. So we're gonna look at the shot on a bigger screen, just see exactly where it might have hit. And we're gonna make a game plan about how we're gonna go at this deer much later in the evening. We got the reinforcements, got Clark and Jeff, and we went back in after dinner, and it was probably a full 3+ hours after the actual shot that we went and looked for.
Okay. He's got 150 yards yet to get to
just now.
Hey!
No, don't hug me. You just...
What you got?
You just let loose, and then you're coming over to share the love with the wind.
That was the deer we were smelling.
Oh, wow.
Look at all this character up through his brows. He's got this cool little thing I was calling a pinky off his right bean. Made him pretty recognizable, and he gave us a slip this morning, opening day. But he came in and offered a shot this afternoon pretty early, and we knew who he was right away. I mean, just look at him, how could you not? We christened the Wolverine for sure, put a big buck at that in the back of it. That was his first voyage, so to be able to do that was nice. And I mean, it just makes the overall job easier in and out of season, and that's what they're intended to do, is to get you into tight spots, into rough, rugged spots, places you wouldn't want to take your truck, even your ranch truck. And we got to showcase that this week.